Have 2 minutes for your opening statement.
I'm Ron McNeil, and I want to be your next congressman. I'm here tonight for all the reasons you've just heard. I waited and waited and waited and been writing a book called Have We Lost Our Minds, which I hope you'll download and read on the website, mcneilforcongress.com. We've got a country that's got to be turned around. I was born in Panama City, raised in a farm in Jackson County, spent most all of my adult life here in Tallahassee or in the Destin area. Been in manufacturing for decades, about 40 years. I'm 65 years old, so I'm older than everybody else up here. And, you know, we worked hard. My older brother, you may know well, he's the guy that invented the round trampoline for the outdoors. We used to make one every 12 minutes of those things, and 3,000 to 4,000 little rebound traps a week. I got in environmental in 84, and after studying it for some while. And I've been in that ever since. I have a dozen patents myself on products. And the last 5 patents, the 97 patent claims granted, is in the environmental field, solving environmental problems for cities in their infrastructure, stormwater and sewer and so forth. So I work with 600 or 700 cities nationwide. I've got patents all over Europe, talking about countries, Canada, Australia, Mexico, everywhere. We do business everywhere. Work with about 600 or 700 cities here in the U.S. I'm going to Washington to build a coalition of all the new people that come in. Because just voting for what's right for our district, that's the minimum we could do. To get out of the pork barrel of politics is a minimum we can do. To make our country operate like we have to operate our businesses. You know, we were just a small business. You try to make a payroll for 180 people on Friday and see how fun it is for a while. And I've been through all the wars. I had 5 different lawsuits where people tried to steal my patent. You know, every one of them. I've had a 10-year war with IRS. We're going to try to get rid of the IRS for you. I think I'll be the worst enemy they ever had going to Washington, D.C. And we're going to make a transformation of America back to the free enterprise system and to our Bill of Rights and Constitution. God bless you. I'm glad to be here tonight.
Now we will begin the question and answer part of the debate tonight. The first 2 questions will have to do with the economy. You will have 90 seconds to respond. You will have 90 seconds to respond. Again, the order chosen randomly. Ms. Olshner, you will be first with this question, and then we will move from there. Question number 1. In light of the current difficult economy with nearly 10% unemployment and a federal debt that could soon overwhelm this country's financial stability. It's a 2-part question. To what causes do you attribute the current economic malaise? And what steps, as a congresswoman, would you propose to set this country's course towards greater economic prosperity and stability? Ms. Olshner, you have 90 seconds.
Well, I'm going to take what I think is the least important question first and deal with it succinctly. The cause is not as important as the remedy and the solution. The cause is overspending. The question is, our ox is in a ditch, and how do we get him out? That's what we really need to focus on because we're in serious economic trouble. There are a number of things that I think that we need to do. Some of them are not popular. One of them is that we need to reform the entitlement program. Our Social Security, our Medicare, our Medicaid is 65% of the budget. It goes up automatically every year. It automatically increases, and it is too large a piece of the budget for us to deal with. We've got to get that under control. We've got to jumpstart the economy, and we've got to encourage people to reinvest in small business. We've got to reduce the tax burden on small businesses. I would like to see capital gains taxes suspended for 24 months as an incentive for people to reinvest in America with looking to eliminate capital gains tax. I would also like to see a payroll tax for employers. This was done for nonprofit and it increased jobs. We need jobs in this country, and I would like to see a payroll on that. Thank you.
Mr. Sutherland, I will repeat the question for you briefly. To what causes do you attribute the current economic malaise, and what steps as a congressman would you propose to set this country's course towards greater economic prosperity and stability? You have 90 seconds.
Clearly the causes are twofold. First is government spending, the lack of having the ability to say no. That is the first cause, I believe. And that has really led us to, I think, the greatest cause, and that is to create an environment of uncertainty. Many of you in this room are business people. You clearly understand that as long as there is an environment of uncertainty, you will not invest. You will not take risk. It wouldn't be prudent. So how do we deal with government spending? How do we deal with an environment of uncertainty? Because we don't trust the leaders that are in control. Well, first and foremost, I believe that we have to call for a radical decrease in government spending. Perhaps 25% has been called for, I know, by the Heritage Foundation. I tend to agree with that. How is that done? Well, that is done through budget cuts, but it can be done very easily and less painfully in Washington, D.C., if they would freeze hiring. With the freezing of hiring and attrition, much of that cut would come in the first 4 years. I also believe that we need to institute a cap on spending. 20% of our GDP needs to be a cap on government spending. That has worked well for us for almost 70 years, and it needs to be in place now. I believe that when you do that, that the $2 trillion of private money will come off the sidelines because you will end uncertainty, and people will again begin betting on America. They will begin investing dollars in this country.
Mr. Hendry, let me repeat the question. To what causes do you attribute the current economic malaise, and what steps as a congressman would you propose to set this country's course towards greater economic prosperity and stability? You have 90 seconds.
Well, the first thing we have to do is convince our current administration that the federal government does not create jobs. There are three things that are causing this. One is too much spending, one is too high tax, and the last is too much regulation. There are programs up on the federal level right now, like education and healthcare, that need to be down on the state and local level where the representatives that you know and you elected can handle these things. The federal government cannot do this. They're too big. The other thing that we have to do is we have to freeze our federal spending at $2.7 trillion, which is what the Treasury bought in last year. We then need to balance the budget. These are the short-term things that we need to do, although we need to make the balanced budget permanent. We also need to get rid of the corporate tax, or lower it at least. We need to get rid of the estate tax, and we need to get rid of capital gains tax because it punishes people who are productive, and that is not right. And that's how you create the environment for growth. But you've got to do them both at the same time. Cut spending and taxes. You can't do one or the other.
Mr. McNeil, to what causes do you attribute the current economic malaise, and what steps as a congressman would you propose to set this country's course towards greater economic prosperity and stability? You have 90 seconds.
That's my favorite question. It's all about power and votes. That's how we got there. Healthcare was about power and votes. England's about 98% of the size of the state of Louisiana, yet there's 1.4 million healthcare workers in England. More than 50% are in administration. Now, can you imagine how many liberal federal employees we'd have in the place of the United States? You'd have 10 to 30 million people employed by the federal government, giving you terrible health care. So all these things that have taken us down this road is about power and votes. As they get power, they give up something. And it's mighty near future they're giving up, as well as our children. Now, to sum it, Ronald Reagan was my mentor. I was with Reagan many times. I was voted number one candidate in the nation by the National Republican Party, with Lee Atwater then, in 82, with Reagan. And that's where it all started. When Reagan set us on a good course, it's been faltering slightly ever since. And now it's in an absolute tornado-ish down spiral, tearing up everything it hits. So we've got to have business, from the money from offshore, onshore, eliminating taxes on corporations, bring the money back into America and build America's businesses. And that's the only way to get back up. Thank you very much.
Mr. Shull, to what causes do you attribute the current economic malaise, and what steps as a congressman would you propose to set this country's course toward greater economic prosperity and stability? You have 90 seconds.
The current situation we're facing, I think, was totally manufactured by the United States government. Their pursuit of affordable housing led to the expansion of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, saying we will underwrite all these risky loans. We will underwrite the LIO loans. And they assume 75 to 80% of the mortgage debt in this country. And when you do that, and eventually the economy hit a downturn, these people weren't able to pay them.